We're getting word today that authorities are closing in on two suspects in the murders of the parents of CLTV's Gerard McClendon. And Gerard is now speaking out about this horrific tragedy. WGN's Jae Miller is joining us from Hammond, Indiana, where the parents lived, with more. Jae?
Hi there, Monica. Police sources are saying that two men were seen attempting to sell property belonging to the McClendons shortly after they were found murdered Monday. For the first time, Gerard McClendon is speaking out about this crime. He says he forgives whoever killed his parents.
I have forgiven the perpetrators. Do I want them caught? Of course. Do I want justice to be served? Of course. But I can't live a productive life just in constant pain.
Gerard McClendon talking for the first time since finding out his parents were brutally murdered earlier this week.
The vision of my parents, you know, being murdered is unbelievable.
His father, 78-year-old Wayman McClendon, and mother, 76-year-old Ruby McClendon, were found dead at a forest preserve in Calumet City Monday. Police believe the couple was killed at their Hammond, Indiana home. While the motive remains unclear, family tells us all signs point to robbery.
They were robbed of life and liberty and the pursuit of happiness in the land of the free and the home of the brave. And they were robbed of that in their own home.
Having to go to the Cook County Examiner's office to identify my parents was the most surreal situation I've ever been in my life. You know, I can't get that vision out of my head.
Hammond police say they are working with the FBI and collecting evidence from the McClendon's car that was found abandoned Wednesday on the Dan Ryan Expressway. For Gerard, who makes a living talking about violence and other issues, he now finds himself front and center of an unimaginable crime.
Every day when I wake up and look at the top story on the news or I look at the newspaper, it's never my family, but it is today.
He is remarkably strong. As we all know, Gerard McClendon ends all of his shows by telling his viewers to be upbeat, to be encouraged, to keep your heads up. Now he finds himself trying to follow his own words. In Hammond, Indiana, Jae Miller, WGN News. Monica, back to you.
Hey, Jae, I think, you know, the folks that watch us have got to realize that those of us who work with Gerard are deeply affected by this as well. I mean, this has been really, really painful this week, especially because, as you've pointed out, he makes his living talking about these issues, but not just talking about them, trying to find solutions. And he's so many times gone off on the senseless violence, and he's been so strong on education and other issues. The fact that he is now having to deal with this in his own personal life, I have a feeling he's going to become a personal hero for many.
A personal hero, and his parents are heroes, were heroes to so many as well. Just an absolute tragedy, Monica.
Jae, thanks a lot. Thanks. Mm-hmm.